Hello everyone, welcome all to our YouTube channel. Hope you all are doing great. In today's video, we will cover Surya Namaskar. Most of the people can do Surya Namaskar by themselves, but they are doing it, not doing it one or two times, they are doing it over and over again. So if they are not doing correctly, they may end up having serious issues. So it's important for everyone to get to know that what are common mistakes that you can do while practicing Surya Namaskar and what are the things that you need to keep in mind and you need to avoid. This is something that everybody need to know, just have a proper knowledge before doing anything. So now let's move on to our today's video. Pose 1, Pranamasana or prayer pose. Make sure your weight should be equally distributed on both feet and feet are parallel to each other. Roll your shoulder back, open your chest, keep your chin parallel to floor and body relaxed. Join your hands in Namaste. Here's how not to do this pose. Don't shift your body weight either on left side or on right side. Don't lean forward or lean backward. Your weight should be equally on both feet. Don't point your feet away from each other or toward each other. Don't contract any of your muscles. Be relaxed and feel expanded. Always keep smiling. Pose 2, Hast Uttanasana or raised arm pose. Pull yourself up, raise your arms up and arch backwards. While expanding your chest, reach for skies with the chest. Here's how not to do the pose. Don't let your head hang loose. You could hurt your neck while doing this. Your head must always be in between your hands. Don't try to overextend, backward bend. Arch will get defined with time by practice. Don't trust too much in first try. You could hurt your back. Pose 3, Hast Padasana or standing forward bend. Bend forward while elongating your spine and keeping your back flat. Place your palm next to your feet. Once you reach maximum stretch of your body, you can tuck your head in. Here's how not to do the pose. Don't round your back in this pose. The aim is not to touch your head to your knee. The aim is to elongate your spine toward the earth. Don't place your hand too away from your feet or leave them hanging in the air. It's okay to bend your knee in order to touch the ground and then gently try to straighten your knee. Don't push your hips backward. Keep your legs parallel to ground. From here, we shall keep position of palms fixed for next of poses. Pose 4, Ashva Sanchalasana or Equestrian Pose. Take your right leg back, place your right knee on mat, point your toe backward, push your hip down, keep your chin up and chest open. One of the variation is where knee is raised off the mat, toes are in contact with mat. Here's how not to do this pose. Don't let knee of your left foot that's in front overshoot your feet. Doing this can lead to knee injuries overnight. Maintain this 90 degree angle. Don't put your leg outside of your palms. Knee is in between both of your arms and right in the middle. Don't push your hip backward. Instead, move it forward and drop it down to feel stretch here on this leg. Bonus tip. If you are not able to directly take your leg back from forward bend, you can bend your knee and then take your right leg back. Pose 5, Dandasana or stick pose. Take your left leg back and keep the body in one straight line right from your head to feet. Here's how not to do this pose. Don't raise your hips to sky. Not hang them low. You can hurt your back. Don't place your body too much to front or back. Your shoulder should be directly above your palms, hand perpendicular to floor. Don't contract your shoulder or move them toward ear. Your shoulder should be relaxed and stable. Bonus tip, spread your fingers on mat to give additional support to your wrist. Pose 6, Ashtanga Namaskar or 8 point salute. Put your knee down, then put your chest down between your palms and place your chin down. Instead of chin, you can also place your forehead on mat. Here's how not to do this pose. Try not to let your belly touch the floor. If you are unable to calm down directly,
You can lie down completely and then come up in knee chest chin position. Now, do not let your elbows away from your body. Keep the elbows tucked in. Pose 7. Bhujangasana or Cobra pose. Slide forward. Raise your chest up and point your toes backward. Now, here's how not to do this pose. Do not raise your shoulder toward ear or bring your shoulder forward. Instead, relax your shoulder, push them backward slightly and open up chest to feel the contraction on your upper back. Do not lock your elbow. Make sure elbows are slightly bent so that muscles get engaged and also so that you do not injure your elbow. Do not raise your hip off the floor. Do not let your head hang back. Instead, look up gently toward the sky. Pose 8. Adho Mukho Svanasana or Downward Facing Dog. Raise your hips towards sky to make an inverted V. Try to place your heels on mat. Elongate your spine and gently try to push your head toward mat. Here's how not to do the pose. Do not make tabletop with your body. We are making inverted V here. Don't bend your knees and do not move your head too much to front or to the back. Your head must be in between your hands. Pose 9. Ashva Sanchalasana. Bring your right leg forward and place in between both of your palms. Place left knee down and point your toes backward. Push your hips down. Keep your chin up and chest open. One of the variation in this pose is where knee is raised off the mat and toe are in contact with mat. You already know what not to do in this pose. Don't let knee of your left foot overshoot your feet. Do not push your hip backward. Instead, move it forward. Bonus tip. If you are not able to bring your leg directly to the front from downward facing dog, you can first put knee of your other leg down and then move your leg forward. You can also use your hands to bring your leg forward in between your palms. But remember, leg should be in between both the palms and not on the outside. Pose 10. Standing forward bend, Hast Padasana. Bring your left leg next to your right leg. Bend forward while elongating your spine. While keep your back flat and place your palm next to your feet. Once you have reached maximum stretch for your body, you can tuck in your head. You already know what not to do in this pose. Don't round your back. Instead, elongate your spine toward earth. Do not push your hips backward. Do hands hanging in the air or place them away from the feet. Bend your knee little if needed. 11. Hast Uttanasana. Raised arm pose. Pull yourself up. Raise your arms up and arched backward while elongating your chest. Reach for skies with your chest. You already know what not to do in this pose. Don't let your head hang loose. You could hurt your neck while doing this. Your head must always be in between your hands. Don't try to overextend backward bend. Arch will get defined with time by practice. Pose 12. Tadasana or Mountain Pose. Straighten your body. Bring the hands down. Relax in this position while looking straight ahead and observe sensation. Here's how not to do this pose. Don't shift your weight either on left or right side. Don't lean forward, lean backward. Your weight should be equally on both feet. Don't point your feet away from each other or toward each other. Keep them parallel to each other. Do not contract any of your muscle. Be relaxed and feel expanded. And always keep smiling.
Now we are gonna to do Surya Namaskar one more time. But this time we'll do it with breathing pattern.
1. Namaste. 2. Breathe in for raised arm pose. 3. Breathe out for forward bend. 4. Take your left leg back. Breathe in for equestrian pose. 5. Breathe out for plank pose. 6. Breathe in as you put your knee down and breathe out as you put your chin down. 7. Breathe in for cobra pose. 8. Breathe out for downward facing dog. 9. Bring your left leg forward. Breathe in for equestrian pose. 10. breathe out for forward bend. 11. Breathe in for raised arm pose. 12. Breathe out and relaxed.